Hey guys, welcome to JPlays. I am Iceman. This is my playthrough of Dungeon Maker 2 for the Sony PSP, played on PC via the emulator PPSSPP. And let me just chuck the volume back on. There we go. Alright, it's taken me quite a few in-game days. We're now up to... Where do I see what day it is? Day 144? I thought that was the day before. I think we're at day 145, I think. I finally hit 1000 HP, so I should now be good to take on Revenger. I'm quite eager to get this game done. I still am divided on whether or not I will continue after that. Right now I've kind of had enough, but you never know, maybe I'll come back after, at a later point in time. For now, I am done. I want to move on and play something else. Thankfully, I've still got Bioshock 2 to play through at the moment, completely different to this game, and Diablo 2, which is kind of similar to this. Well, I don't know. Similar-ish on a very borderline basis, the fact that they're both RPGs and that's it. I think everything else is different. When we go to the dungeon, you'll see I just about got that floor done for the 10th. I just literally need to just place two more rooms and then it's done. Everything else is in there. There's nothing else left placed there, really. Got it just about maxed. The first one with a rating over 100 as well. So that's good. As I said, I'm divided on whether I'll actually continue beyond the endgame. I mean, it does interest me to be able to play as the female character, which in my case I named Aquanessa, and to see the content of the ruins, like beyond the points where I've seen them in my earlier playthrough. But for now, I just want to get this game done. So... I just bought this just before recording. A new armor set unlocked, the silver armor set. Interesting. I kind of like the look of the other one. But that one. Okay. Alright, normally I would go and place marble. By the way, marble's just about three quarters done on April 1. But what it matters. But let's go do this thing. I want to beat this game. As you can see, if you can see the map there, literally, you can see my mouse cursor. I don't see it in the recording. Give me a sec, I'll see if I can... It should be showing my cursor. Anyway, if you can see my cursor, I don't see it in the recording, but anyway, down the bottom middle, there's one section left with two rooms. So other than that, I'm done. Alright. Okay, let's do this. I had to pick up another spell as well, because apparently this boss Revenger mainly sticks to physical attacks in the types of stuff he does. So that's the main thing, get shield, the shield spell, which protects, which takes off half of the damage from that. I've also loaded myself up with loads of healing potions, rebirth, which will save me, and magic and stuff. Yeah, but this boss Revenger comes in two forms. I gave it a test, by the way, after I finished the recording of the last one, and I was, without much trouble, able to get through the first form. It's the second one that's harder. So let's go and do this. Nice to hear some new music. So Crimson is his right-hand man. Bad translation down the bottom there. Can't we not the common goal of vengeance against the gods? What is a man? A miserable little pile of secrets. Smiles are nothing more than a social tool for the use of vile, powerless human beings. Smiles are a mark of the wisdom necessary for living in peace. Peace, tolerance, smiling faces, how superficial, how vulgar. A human being insisting that compromise is wisdom. I hate you. This is just like what I was just saying. What is a man? A miserable pile of secrets. I'll tell you what time it is. It's time for me to defeat a demonic villain for world peace. Prepare to fight. Damn it. Okay, we're on to the second form, Revenger. Thank you.
half health. So about a quarter health now. Got this. Let me see. Oh. Stun must be me. Oh yeah! Revenger is defeated. Springer. Well, and that's not as good as my current weapon. Wow, a booze bottle is better than the weapon that Revenger drops? Okay. Cool. Alright, so with that, this game is done. Well, as far as the main boss that they tell you to go out and seek out and destroy. Alright, quickly, I'm just going to do a couple of routine stuff for the level. That was a good battle, though. A lot more reasonable than the final boss of the original Dungeon Maker. Like, that one, Revenger, as long as you go there with enough items, you're fine. Yeah, I'm all good with that. See, perfect timing. Because this has now, this level is now finished as well. So, awesome. Alright, level done. Let's return back to town, get the credits, see the ending. Let's see what happens. I mean, Revenger, defeating Revenger was the entire point of the game. Though now we know Crimson was his second in command. They talk about her like she's your girlfriend or something. I keep saying, like, isn't there like a massive age difference between the two characters? I'm telling you, they're talking about her like she's your girlfriend. Oh God. What, the Revenger? She doesn't know who Revenger is? Oh my God. Has she been in a cave? You know? He doesn't even know who Revenger is. All he cares about is food. Oh my God. You are saying them out loud. Well, you're saying them in text. And nothing from Nico? Oh. Okay, what does Aquanessa have to say? So that was Dungeon Maker 2. Firstly, I'll say it is a big improvement over the first one. There's a lot less annoying monsters, but I will. I'll start with the good and then I'll go to the bad. So, the positives is there's. I like the new monsters they've added to it. The story is excellent. It's good, actually. Not excellent. Good. Being able to go to the ruins, like having the ruins part of the game, of the different elements, is great. I like that. I like the fact that you're training up to be new dungeon makeup apprentice. So I like that. I like the story stuff with Crimson and Revenger. That's cool. The boss battles were all good. Very good, actually. I would say the boss battles in this were better than in the first one. First one, though, and had a much harder final battle, but I liked this one much better. I liked all the new monster stuff they added in. I liked the improvements to the dungeon types of rooms that you can make. New music, at least at first, is really good. And then, in here. But I like the overall improvements. Oh, and the fact that you have a menu that you have that can assist you. That makes a huge difference. In the first one, you didn't have that, and love the dungeons is a really different problem. Having Genyu makes a huge difference. On the negative side, I'll say there was not enough enemy variety. Like, even though there are some good new monsters in this, there's not enough variety. The damn orcs and, kobolds and stuff, you're fighting them from the first level, and even right up until the last one, you're still fighting them. So, this game could have used more variety, and had level-specific monsters. Well, they do have level-specific monsters, but have it be only those monsters that you see on those levels, rather than the same damn orcs and kobolds in every friggin' level. Just needs more variety. That's all. And also, music variety. No, you hear the same songs in so many levels. It gets really grating on you after a while. If it wasn't for me recording, I would just chuck the game on mute and then, like, listen to video game music playing. I love the town music in this, though. And as I said, I do like the music that's in this game. It's just that if there's not enough variety, that's it. Just needs more variety. But other than that, it has been a great pleasure to play through this game again. I am very curious as to being able to play as your apprentice now. How quickly. Let's see what happens the next day. I just want to see. So what happens now? 16. I'll do that. Go wrong. How old are you supposed to be in this game? 30 something? I don't know, you look like you're in your 20s. But if she's like 16, that is so old. The people in the town were saying, you better be taking that Quinessa on a date today. I'm like, then that means she was like 15 at the time. God damn. That's so wrong. Is that like a cult or thing? I mean, nothing by that afterwards. I don't know. Okay, sure. So, who am I now? The icon's different for the player character now. Built up resistance. Can she equip Chaos Bringer? No, she can't. Okay. So she can carry daggers, staff. Okay. Carry a shield? Yep. If she can carry a shield, let's change characters. I've got a funny feeling I played at least a little bit of it in my other playthrough. Just that when they're switching characters, that rings a bell somewhere. I mean, I got loads of money right now. Oh, 36,000. Okay. Nice ring. Thank you. But Ice Ring is dropped by the Lizard Leader. Found on Lizard Leader on the 11th floor also, and the Water Ruins. Does she have her own inventory? Yes, she does. Now, on my main character. Yeah, fire dagger. Okay. That's worse than what I got. Okay. All right. Let's see what we can buy from the store. So short sword is better than dagger. Noble dagger is better. Kunai is better. Poison dagger is better. Oh, she can't have a bow at the same time? Okay. Okay. Thank you. Ah, okay, because it's not. It was great at the top. Okay. This I only found recently. It's a burn ring. So for Bone Ring, skeletons drop them in altar and jail rooms. What's altar? Loki's ring. So Loki's ring. So apparently succubuses drop them. And magic corridors. Well, I don't have magic corridors. Not yet. Yeah, nothing new to say? It's his first time talking to Aquanessa, and that's all he's got to say? Got run out of money. Okay, this is gonna be challenging. All right. Ah, she can carry a bow as a second weapon. Okay. Oh, I haven't given her a root thingy. Thing I need to get off the main character. Interesting. Okay. Thank you. fun. I think I remember trying to play as her. It was just really difficult. Oh, I've got all the spells, same spells. So that's good. Ooh, her range is way less. What's a place?
Thank you.
interesting playing as a much lower in attributes character. Plus, very different kind of playstyle. Leave it at that for now. Every level needs at least one bar, one kitchen. And I might add in one bedroom. A big one. Yeah, she doesn't move as fast as the main character, right? Good enough, she's like full-blood human though. And the main character guy was half-human, half-demon. Oh, I already got a bar on this level, okay. Alright, I've already got a bar. Holla. Man, it's weird not having long range with your blades. Really makes a difference. Huh? Turning back to town. He's making the bar. One character per day. So for this character, if I did choose to keep playing it, the primary focus for a little while would be getting the health up to like a much, much, much bigger amount. The thing is, I think a lot of the food stuff has ran out. That's right. Thank you. plus 20, MP plus 20. Oxford. Foxfair is dropped by Foxo Ninetales. It says Foxo Ninetales carry them in 11th floor pilot rooms. Okay. Ah, that's a shame. Not as good as my current one. Though it does give better resistance. I'll be back in a little bit, so let's just take a break. Thank you. thing there is he's asking for Loki's ring, but that only drops from succubuses that are found on magic corridors, and I can't make magic corridors. Would be a type that's probably just there. Ah, phone ring. Got it. That'll help. The main thing that sucks with her is it's just a very short attack range. Now the game was saying, go check out the city on water and see what's there. That sounds a bit dangerous with this character, but... I guess we'll see what happens. Oh, I'm so under level for this place. He mentioned getting a fire compass from the fire ruin. Yeah. Now it's telling me to go back to town, okay? Find them in 11th floor magic corridors. Oh wow, 11th floor. What's with this game and smiling? They got something against it. Ah. I real archaeologist. Should be a real archaeologist. Okay, that's better. So now we're talking 37. That is really disturbing. The little boy wants to go on a date with an older guy. God, that is very messed up. Fire compass. Thank you. I don't know if she could defeat one of those. Let's see, Hellhound. What's the best thing I can get? Magic definitely is important. Getting health up though is probably of higher importance. Need to get to at least 300 in health. Take a while. Alright, well, I'm going to end this one here. I'm still undecided on if I'll keep playing, though the story is still continuing on, so I am more leaning towards more of a yes than a no. If I continue on, I'll definitely, you know, keep putting out more videos. So, hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you'd like to be notified about when I go about putting up more videos, if there are going to be, which is quite likely, in the Dungeon Maker 2 playthrough series, be sure to subscribe to the YouTube side of things, be notified when those videos are made available, or click follow or subscribe on Twitch to watch me play through this live. And with that, guys, have a good one. Really good to finally get Revenge out of the way, and, you know, to be able to get the chance to play as the female character for a difference in perspective. Alright guys, have a good one.